We're in First News today at the field site of some very interesting plants. They're called parsley, and I always wondered about those. My mother used to put those on our plates, or they'd be on the plates at the restaurant, and we sort of put it over to the side. Mother said, well, eat that, George. That'll help to take away any breath. It's a breathalyzer. And I said, okay. So is that true, Rick Rademacher?
I don't know. I've never tried it. I just eat what's on the plate and leave that one behind.
Okay. Rick Rademacher is the general manager for the southern region of Cellular American, and he's a fellow that helps to make sure that all these crops are coming out of the field in good order. And Rick, this has been a really big season for you. You've got parsley growing here, all kinds of different vegetables within 100 yards of here.
Yeah, this farm is kind of unique, and we've got a lot of different minor crops, as we call them, where we only grow 1 or 2 acres a week through the season.
Now, Rick, are you concerned in growing these crops like methyl bromide, for example? Is that one of the chemicals that is important to you as a minor crop grower?
Well, it's not one that we use per se, but I know it is one that's used on a lot of other minor crops. We don't have very many pesticides on those crops to begin with, and the ones that we do have, we use very carefully, and they're pretty valuable to us.
You'd like to grow your crops as close to organic as you possibly can, I understand.
Well, we try to put as few inputs as we can because of money. We don't like to spend any money we don't have to, and all those chemicals cost a lot of money.
Well, it looks like the crop's doing quite well. Parsley is one that is very interesting. Now, your buyers have to find buyers for parsley all over the United States.
Well, big chain stores and institutional distributors will buy it, and a pallet may be broken down and distributed to 10 or 12 different locations.
And parsley's not one that you see many consumers going in and buying a bunch of parsley. I have never seen that.
Well, they do a little bit. Around the holidays, people use a lot more parsley for garnish, and also it's used pretty good as a fresh addition to dishes.
Well, let's talk about this crop. These folks are cutting this pretty much like I've seen some others crop. They're bunching it and so on.
Yeah, they cut it off a little above ground level and put a bunch together with a twist tie. And there's about 5 dozen bunches per box, so the box will weigh about 25 to 30 pounds.
Now, these folks here in the field make pretty good money, don't they?
They do pretty well. They definitely earn the money they get, but it's well above minimum wage, and they're on a piece rate, so the more work they get done, the more they make.
And, of course, they are sort of, what do we call it, quality control, too?
Each person is an inspector. And as they work, they take out things they don't like, things that have the wrong color or wrong size or defects or dirt or something in them, and they clean it up as they go.
Now, this, of course, after this box, like they're doing here, they're putting it into the boxes. How many to the box of this parsley?
5 dozen bunches of parsley per box.
Which is about, what, 24, 25 pounds, you say?
25 up to 30 pounds.
Okay. Now, this goes off to the cooler, and what happens there?
Well, they're loaded in the field as a pallet, and the pallet is bound together. And they go to the hydro cooler, which means they're bathed with water as they're cooled to help refresh the crop and cool it more efficiently.
Does that mean that the water is forced through the boxes?
It's sprayed on, and it goes through the boxes, and then the cooler pulls out the excess moisture.
Okay, and that, of course, cools them down real quickly, doesn't it?
Yeah, it takes, depending on how much field heat's in there, anywhere from 15 to 35 minutes.
This crop will be going all over the United States?
Yeah, it'll be going to distributors and restaurants and chains, and it'll be broken down once it gets to destination, and maybe only 1 or 2 boxes per location.
Okay, Rick, and this crop will be out of the ground. When will you be finished?
We're going to harvest this till the end of March.
Okay, Rick Rademacher is the Southern Regional Manager for Cellular American and the folks who bring you a lot of vegetables each and every day of the week. George Gadley, KYMA, First News Today.